Well, childcare isn't the only sector getting financial relief this morning. Aussie car buyers could soon be given tax breaks that cut the cost of electric vehicles by thousands of dollars after a landmark deal in the federal parliament.
James Ward from Drive joins us now with more. Good morning to you. How much are Australians set to save under this deal?
Yeah, good morning, guys. Look, it's actually quite a good deal. It's the fringe benefit tax exemption. And so there's a few things here that you need to tick the boxes. The car needs to be less than around $70,000 and you need to buy it on a novated lease. But if you do those things, it will save you roughly 30% of the car's cost. So if you're buying, a Tesla Model 3, Australia's best-selling electric car, it'll save you roughly $5,000 a year over a four-year lease. So around 20 grand or about 30%, which is pretty impressive.
That's really helpful and might actually get some people over the line to buy them if they can, you know, charge them in their home. So how will you know if you're eligible and if your car fits the criteria for a tax break?
Well, this is the thing. So having the car below that threshold is the key. So the Tesla Model 3, you've got things like the MG ZSEV, the little BYD Auto 3. There's a bunch of new cars coming next year, but even I'm standing in front of some chargers here in very sunny Lithgow, so I apologise for the squinting. And a Kia EV6 has rolled in just while I've been waiting. That's just above the threshold. So there are not too many, but there will be more below the threshold. Plus, your employer needs to have a novated lease program. And so if you work for a larger business, odds on they do, but a lot of smaller business, either owners or employees, your business may not do it. So it is a few little steps to get there. But if you do fit the right criteria, it can be a very good saving.
There is already, though, a bit of a demand issue when it comes to electric vehicles. What's this going to do to supply?
Well, this is the thing. We're incentivising the purchase of electric cars and every single one of them has a wait list. There's no warehouse somewhere full of these things waiting for people to buy them. And what's interesting is you know, the government is trying to incentivise people. And yes, this may be the sort of thing you might go, well, I could get that Mazda or I could get that electric car now as I renew my lease. So it might be a few things to get people over the line. But behind me are two electric chargers. These are NRMA chargers here in Lithgow. More of those is what we need. More public charging infrastructure points. That would be the big help to support people who are currently owning and buying electric cars.
Well, it's good to see that's happening in Lithgow too. So what's your advice to people who are unsure if an electric car is right for them?
Yeah, look, do your research is the thing. And I know that's a sort of a bit of a throwaway term. They are a choice. They don't suit everybody. If you are using your car predominantly for city driving and you can charge it off street, it's a really, really easy decision to make. If you want one, it'll work for you. But this car behind me, the couple rolled in. It's on Queensland number plates. They're touring the country. So you can get out there on the open road, but you do need to use those chargers around. If you're doing a lot of touring, though, or you need to tow or you need to do things, we're not there yet. So what we're saying to a lot of prospective buyers is your first electric car might be a great second car. So if you're in a two-car household, keeping the ute or the SUV that's a diesel or a petrol to run day-to-day and then have an electric car to use around the city to do your shopping and school drop-off, that's a great way to try and do it. But do some research, come over to Drive, have a look. We've got stacks of information it's only going to get better. We're seeing so many more new cars hit the market next year. It's a very exciting time.